Hi, hello friends, it's me Manivanan. Now you are watching Rebels of English. This is my first video explaining a literary work in English. Keep watching and drop your comments. Your comments are valuable to me. It helps me to improve myself. So please don't forget to drop your feedbacks. In this video, I'm going to talk about the poem Wind, written by Ted Hughes. Let's start. Poem is a piece of writing which expresses feelings and ideas with intent. Particular attention is given to diction, rhythm, imagery, and sometimes rhymes. Poem, in my opinion, is the best form of literature. It's like a painting. Without a perspective, without aesthetic sense, one could not understand it, could not feel it. If you have a good aesthetic sense, poetry could lift you and make you fly in the sky. In a reading hall, it can give you the feel of dancing in rain. Ted Hughes. The poem Wind is written by Ted Hughes, an American writer. He was born on August 17, 1930 in Yorkshire, England. In 1956, he met his future wife, Sylvia Plath, at the lunch party for the literary magazine he co-founded, St. Podolph's Review. A year later, in 1957, he published his first book, The Hawk in the Rain, which includes the poem Wind. He left Sylvia Plath in 1962 and married Carol Orchard in 1970. On 28 October 1998, in Devonshire, England, cancer took his life. Ted Hughes' poetic style is original and he is influenced by Hopkins, Dylan Thomas, and his wife Sylvia Plath. His usual tendency is to use tough vocabulary and put words together in unusual combination. You can see that yourself once we go through this poem. He has written many poetry collections, volumes of translations, short story collections, prose, plays, and books for children. His birthday letters, published in 1998, got him many awards. Forward Poetry Prize for Best Collection in 1998, T.S. Eliot Prize in 1998, and British Book of the Year Award in 1999. His Iron Man became the basis of Pete Townshend's rock opera of the same name and of the animated film The Iron Giant.
The title itself reminded me of another poem, an ode, Ode to the West Wind, written by P.B. Shelley. Of course, it belongs to British literature, and he also talked about the wind, but he described both sides of west wind, good and bad, preserver and destroyer. I have already uploaded a video on that in Tamil. Maybe in future, I will try to re-upload it in English. In this poem, Wind, Ted Hughes, using many images, vividly describes the power of wind, the rage of nature. In this poem, Ted Hughes talks about his experience with the storm, wind, when he was with someone else. He was in an isolated house when the storm hit. There was no one else to help or to contact. The storm lasted even after the sunrise. In the morning, he risked his life and went out to get coal and returned. In that house, he was with someone else. He didn't mention who it was. It could be his lover, wife, friend, or a family member, or even a stranger who took shelter because of the storm. Because of the weather and atmosphere, they could not do anything but to sit in front of a fireplace and watch and listen to the thunder of the storm wind. The poem starts by describing the house he was residing at. It was an isolated house. He gives it the image of a lone boat which was far out at sea all night. Then the further lines shows the intensity of the wind, how powerful and fierce it was. The storm, wind, made the branches of the trees to crash with each other, and the rock of the hills made booming sounds. In the next line, by using the term stampeding, Ted Hughes gives the wind the image of horses. The wind makes the fields to hit against the wall of the house, which was usually built by woods. So, eventually, it makes sounds like the stampeding horses. Because of the storm and the house was isolated, he could not see anything outside the house, blinding. From the first line of the second stanza, we come to know that the storm lasted the whole night, even after the sunrise. After the sunrise, the next day, the sky was orange. Then only he could see around the house. The wind moved the rocks of the hills. It was like the hills have changed its places. As the clouds are messy, the rays of the sun was looked like the wind had swords made of light. and the sky with messy and constantly changing clouds looked like the eye of a madman. We can also take it as an angry eye. Because of the color of the sky and the messy clouds, it might be looked like the nature is angry on humans. The reason is, as you have guessed, we spoiled the earth. Of course, we can see several articles, memes saying that humans don't deserve the earth. Let's come back to the topic. In the third stanza, he says that he went out and walked along the house side to the coal house. If we read those lines again, we could understand few more things. The previous stanzas showed the intensity of the wind. The term wet shows it was cold. Because of using the fireplace whole night to keep them warm from freezing cold, they could be run out of coal. So he came out to get some, walked along the house side. From this, what I understood was, it is still storming and the intensity of the wind is still not lessened. To avoid being carried away by the wind, he walked along the house side. Even in that fear, he dared to look up and as a result, the wind dented his eyes. Can you imagine how fierce the wind was? In the first stanza, he told that the hills were boomed. Again, he talks about the hills. He says that the hills feared that they would lose their tent top and tried to hold it by straining its gyro. The fields were constantly shaking, trembling, and the skyline looked ugly. It was like at any second the sky would shatter and vanish. The wind has thrown away a magpie and bended a gull like iron bar. All these show the power of the wind. Magpie and gull are seabirds. They have seen many storms and survived them, but the wind just thrown them away. Does it mean that the wind didn't show mercy on them? Drop your thoughts. Then the poem sheds light back on the house. The house rang like a green goblet. It was like an alarm that the house was gonna be shattered. In the upcoming lines only, he talks about him and another person with him. Throughout the poem, he didn't mention who it was. As I said earlier, it could be his lover, wife, friend, family member, or some stranger who took shelter for the storm. He says that he, with the second person, was sitting in a chair in front of the fireplace. They were frozen in fear of death. They are not in the mood to read a book or indulge in a discussion or each other. They do nothing but watch the fire blazing, windows tremble, and feel the house move. They were like the stones that are crying out under the horizons. As I already said, he didn't mention with whom he was there. But from the year he met with Sylvia Plath, 1956, and the year this book published, 1957, I assume that it must be his wife Sylvia Plath. Based on that, let me share my thoughts about this poem. He wrote about his experience when he took a vacation with his wife, or considering the house and wind as metaphor for their heart and ego, probably they were in an argument and ended up not talking to each other. Well, in the poem, he wrote that we cannot entertain each other. And another thing, we can also think like this. Though there is a storm between their relationship, they are still together. They did not sink. They did not abandon it. Even the house rang like it is about to be shattered. They did not leave the house, their relationship. This shows their love, their bond. Also, we can assume it in another way, which is he could not leave the house, their relationship, because of the disastrous weather. It may be. That's all, my friends. These are my thoughts. As I said, this is my first video in English. So please give me your feedbacks, like what are the things I have to improve, what should be changed, things like that. If you like this video, like it, share it. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching. See you soon in my next video.